talking over the other one, you know.
Well, let's start again in the light because I can see you better now. Tell me all about this car. Don't take you a couple of seconds. 2.5 minutes.
This is a Rover P4, P for project. The fourth project by the Rover company at Solihull. Built between 1949 and 1964. This is a Rover 100 model. The number designates just the engine type and so forth, insofar as it's the engine for the car. Built in 1962. Can you hear me?
Up your voice a little bit now.
Tell the neighbours.
Up it a little bit, because it is a bit low, a bit soft. Your voice is soft.
This particular type was built, model was built between 1959 and 1962. And this is one of the last that we've built.
Up your voice, up your voice. You're whispering. Just up your voice. Just a little bit, because it is soft. Your voice is soft. You're very softly spoken. Just up it a little bit.
So the colour is shadow green, called shadow green. Most of the Rover colours of the period were nice, subtle colours.
Hi, Pat. He's giving me the lowdown on this beautiful machine. You should be showing this. You should be in shows. Honestly, a car like this.
I'll just open the bonnet now.
Look at this, Pat. Have you seen under the bonnet?
Yeah.
Nice, isn't it?
It's lovely.
To me, that looks like something out of a time shift. It looks gorgeous. That would look fantastic in a programme like Heartbeat.
Oh, it would.
Yeah. Now, don't be too long, because I'm missing you already. And I want you to talk to Maria in a minute. It'll be lovely when you get a chance to say hello to her. Pat, Andy, tell me all about the engine.
Yes, well, shall I tell you all about the engine now?
Yeah, go on.
So overhead inlet, standard overhead inlet side exhaust system, engine system, which was current at the time. Six cylinders.
Can you hear the car?
Doing a brake cut.
Can you hear the car going past?
Yeah.
You have to stop then, because all we'll hear is the engine. So start that bit again. Can you hear the dog?
Yeah.
We're not going to get through this clip, are we? Sorry, the car's gone now, so try and see what you can do about telling me that bit, the engine's...
Right, well, it says overhead inlet side exhaust engine. Six cylinders. Total cc is 2,625 cc. Brake horsepower about 79 horsepower. The gear ratios are subject to the weight of the car, which is 1.5 tons. It takes about 22 seconds to get to 60 miles an hour from a standing start, which is pretty good for this car from those days. Engine features, obviously the radiator, the oil bath air cleaner. In there is a big Y mesh thing, like a big Brillo pad, which cleans the air, which is sucked in, comes through the oil, comes through there into the air silencer, which then goes into the carburetor system. It's an SU carburetor, which then goes into the engine and works on the internal combustion system.
Do you know the four strokes of the cycle?
Yes.
What are they?
Oh, you want me to tell them? Oh.
Because I know them as well.
Yes,
I'm going to test you now, see if you know. What's the first cycle?
Well, the first cycle is the inlet. No, the
induction.
Induction.
Induction. Yeah, compression.
Power,
ignition. Exhaust.
No, power. Exhaust.
Ignition and power is the same thing.
Okay.
That's what they call it. Yeah. But yeah, you know your stuff.
So, created by a German called Otto.
Otto Daimler.
Yeah. Daimler.
Otto Daimler.
Otto Daimler.
Otto Daimler. The four-stroke cycle. Induction, compression, ignition, exhaust. But as us coppers used to say, suck, squeeze, bang, blow, which is exactly what we used to say for the purpose of the tape. Suck.
For the purpose of the taste. Suck, squeeze, bang, and blow.
Yeah, that's the four.
Sounds much more interesting.
That's the four cycles.
It's the four cycles. Any other cycles you might use as well. starting handle is here. The beauty of a starting handle is that you can get the gap between the points spot on, basically. When you put new contact sets in, you can get the gap. Take the plugs out and turn the engine on the handle, and you can get it down to spot on, virtually, the gap.
You're getting through that mess a bit. You're still drinking that, are you?
Yeah, so it goes through to the cockpit, you know. Right, that's it, really, basically.
Hang on. Tell me all about this side of the engine. What's going on over here?
Well, this is the current voltage regulator. Basically, it controls the electrical current to and from the engine. This is the fuse box, so to speak. Little fuse in there with a spare fuse in the bottom. That's the brake fluid reservoir. The wires coming off the reservoir go to a light on the dashboard, which indicates whether it's getting empty.
Did you just recently change that hose you were telling the viewers?
Yes, viewers. I just recently changed this hose. It was perished, and I've put this other new one on. And led the heating system, so as it now is okay.
Mm-hmm. Fantastic. Is it raining?
Yes, it's raining now.
Shall we go in?
It is.
Did you just swear?
No.
Yeah. Are you going to drive it back in the garage? Shall I film you driving it in? It's a lovely car. That's a big, big car, because this is a big garage and that car's filling this garage.